So Republicans are just absolutely bananas, okay? They're just fucking bananas. And at this point, I feel like they're just freestyling. They're just trying to come up with like different ways to say women can't control their own bodies. Women should not be able to control their own bodies. Like, and they're basically empty baby incubators. Okay. They're a vessel. So I really, you guys know this, I admire the brain rot. Right, I admire the brain rot.
Hey, Hussein.
So I love when conservatives decide, let's find a new and more creative way to say what we've been saying for a while, that like women are baby incubators and they should not be able to get abortions, right? Madison Cawthorn, friend of the show, the intellectual titan that he is, decided to say this in his general speech in the U.S. House.
Madam Speaker, imagine you've just walked out of this chamber, and outside is a gorgeous sunset.
Finished watching,
you have a Polaroid camera,
was
and you snap a beautiful picture,
and now
and the great photo prints out the front. You hold it and shake it, waiting for the picture to appear. But suddenly, someone walks by and snatches your photo, ripping it to shreds. You're stunned. You cry, why did you destroy my picture? The person replies, oh, it wasn't a picture. It wasn't fully developed yet. All of us in this room realize how asinine that reasoning is. That
Okay. Yeah, no, that is asinine. Madison Cawthorn is already a sexless nerd, okay? But nothing proves that more than this. On top of the fact that he also very clearly does not know how biology works, like how a woman's body operates. Like, the only person that would ever make this comparison is a person who literally does not understand the concept of childbirth and pregnancy and how a child is conceived, okay? So, first of all, the difference between an unwanted pregnancy and a wanted one is the consent of the carrier. So, if you want to use a Polaroid example, the woman wants to have that photo. So, if you're talking about like a woman who wants to get an abortion, then she's ripping the fucking photo. So, why are you getting mad at her? I don't even understand how anyone could be like, I'm really fucking spitting right now. Okay, I'm fucking spitting. So, the analogy doesn't work because, you know, the concept of a Polaroid is a ridiculous one to make a comparison to, because you're not like, the Polaroid is not sucking up your body's you know, fluids and nutrients to incubate, okay? And even then, if you want to have that pregnancy, if you want to carry that pregnancy to term and someone forcibly aborts it, then that's incredibly immoral and illegal.
Photo was transforming into a beautiful image. This illustration by Seth Gruber is simple, but it's what our nation has done to the most precious image of all, the image of God.
Most precious image of all, the image of God. Like a tear drops down. Dude, that's so cheesy, dude. God, he's so cheesy.
But it's what our nation has done to the most precious image of all, the image of God. Madam Speaker, a silent genocide has slipped beneath the conscience of America. Precious works of our Creator, formed and set apart, meet death before they breathe life. Eternal souls woven into earthen vessels, sanctified by Almighty God and endowed with the miracle of life, are denied their birth by a nation that was born.
I just don't believe he's religious. Like, that's the other part of this. Where, like, I don't think, I mean, he's too much of a fucking Zoomer to be like, actually religious, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think he is. I just can't see him being like a religious person.
Freedom.
My man said the silent genocide of babies, dude. Madam Speaker, why can I not get coochie? Madam Speaker. It's terrible.
God's breath of life blown away by the breath of man. This cruel and fallen world may seem too filthy for their very presence. But these precious temples are crafted in the image of God himself. One day, perhaps when science darkens the soul of the left, our nation will repent. But until then, the carnage of this unconscionable deed will stain the fabric of our nation. I hope that the Supreme Court overturns Roe v. Wade. I hope that we stop the genocide of abortion in this country. With that, I yield back.
Brave. Freaking brave, dude. I have a conservative friend who makes campaign ads for Republicans, and even he says Madison Cawthorn is the stupidest person he's ever worked with. It's really good. He was really spitting on this one. I love that. I love when conservatives are like, let's try something different today. Okay. Let's do something different. Let's go outside of the weird March for Life talking points that we got. You know what I mean? Here's what Ben Shapiro had to say about women getting abortions in Texas.
Even if Roe versus Wade is overturned, the law in New York is not going to be the same as the law in Mississippi. And everybody who studies law understands this, because that was the case before Roe versus Wade. California had some pretty liberal abortion laws. New York had some pretty liberal abortion laws. And
what was the reason, I wonder, that Roe versus Wade happened, though? Like, why? Why did it had to happen then? You know, liberal activist judges in the Supreme Court. Right? Is that why? Is that why it happened? Okay, good. So we both agree, okay, that the Supreme Court is just bullshit.
Texas had some pretty strict abortion laws before Roe versus Wade went into place. Nonetheless, the fact that the Supreme Court is now considering the possibility of disestablishing a constitutional right to abortion, which again, does not exist. It was made up out of whole cloth in an entire line of cases.
Every law, by the way. Like, I love when conservatives, in an effort to dismantle a particular subject, we'll just straight up argue against the entire concept, okay? Oh, it was made out of whole cloth. Oh, you mean the Constitution, dude? That's kind of how laws work. Like, the constitutional interpretation is also, like, the legal interpretation, the originalist interpretation versus, like, Constitution being, like, a living organism aren't necessarily all that far apart. It's just a different way to say, I'm biased towards this side of the political spectrum versus that, okay? So, yeah, it is all made up whole cloth, technically. Those are all laws. There is no, like, law of nature there, okay?
This is stretching all the way back to Griswold through Eisenstadt v. Baird, all the way up through Planned Parenthood versus Casey. That supposed constitutional right to abortion was made up directly out of the colons of Supreme Court justices who had political leanings in favor of a pro-choice position. Even if it were overruled,
okay, and now it's being overruled potentially by those who have an anti-choice position. That's what he's going to say, because that's giving the game away. And I agree. If Ben came out and said that, I would agree, because I do agree with that. I think it's bullshit. The originalist interpretation, as I've said time and time again, okay, the constitutional interpretation from an originalist perspective is just reactionary politics painted with an intellectual patina. Whenever people say, like, oh, I'm an originalist, like, no, you're that's not a real position that you consistently hold. You are just simply a Republican or a conservative, and you're trying to make it work by saying, like, oh, actually, there's a real way that I'm looking at it, an intellectual way that I'm looking at the situation. Bullshit. Not real.
If ladies want to get abortions, all they have to do is not be in Texas.
Great. That's not so simple. Even with the trap laws, in a Roe versus Wade world that we live in, it's already profoundly difficult for people to be able to get safe and easy abortions, okay? In red states already. It's been functionally fucking destroyed. The Roe v. Wade precedent has been destroyed in red states. They do everything they can to create fake clinics that can legally lie to you, or the doctor can legally lie to you about, like, the baby has a heartbeat right now. Like, you can listen to classical music. It's incredibly difficult because, like, there's very few abortion clinics that you can go to, or places where they can offer abortion that you can go to. These six states show how the Supreme Court could end abortion access without overruling Roe v. Wade. In 24 states, there are unnecessary restrictions on the provisions of abortion care. So, time and time again, countless amounts of studies have concluded that making abortions illegal or restricting access to abortions does not actually stop abortions from happening. If you want to stop abortions from happening, the best possible thing you can do is offer reproductive health care services to people at an early age and educate them on sex ed and improve their material conditions. Okay? Those are the effective ways of reducing the number of abortions because you're reducing the number of unwanted pregnancies. And I don't mean abstinence-only sex education. I mean real sex education. Okay? Restricting access to abortions actually does not decrease the number of abortions overall. It just makes, it just creates a back alley abortions. Because at the end of the day, the difference between a baby and a parasite is consent from the mother. That's it. If something is growing inside of you and you do not want to carry that pregnancy to term for a multitude of different reasons, you should be able to get an abortion safely, free of scrutiny, and for free.
And they could go over the border to Mexico, and presumably they'd be able to get an abortion there. They could go over to California, get an abortion there. Listen, I would prefer a nationwide regime wherein no one can get an abortion, except in cases where the mother's life is in danger. But that's not the way the federalist system works. And
why? Why, except for when the mother's life is in danger? Let's think about that for a second. Except for cases where the mother's life is in danger implies that there are instances where the autonomy of the carrier overrides the potential life. Why can't you expand on that? You are greatly, you are basically fucking putting people into a situation where they are forcibly carrying a pregnancy to term. If it's still alive, if the mother is still alive, you can't recognize that only in instances where that life might be in jeopardy. I think that the autonomy of the living, breathing human being that is the mother, the carrier, is more important in all of the instances and overrules and overrides the potential life that may exist. That's just the way I see it. Because if you were honest and you're like, well, the baby needs to fucking come out one way or the other, then you have to force a woman to carry pregnancy to term even if their life is in jeopardy. Because the fetus is more important. Fetus's life is more important. The potential to life of the fetus is more important and more sacred than the life of the mother. Because that is what pro-abortion, or not pro-abortion, sorry. That is what anti-choice pro-forced pregnancy carriers believe. They're always, in every single circumstance, putting the interests of the fetus and the potential viability of that fetus outside the womb over the interests of the carrier, over the interests of the mother.
And because of that, that means that there will be state differences in how abortion law is applied. But the left is losing it.
This is always your take on this growing up in Turkey, or did you come to this conclusion later? An incredibly Americentric opinion there. There are plenty of countries where you can get safe and free abortions. In Turkey, there's a public healthcare system. That means there are public hospitals that the government pays for with your taxes. You can get abortions in those public hospitals. That's right. Some places might not do the procedure, and I know Turkish chatters will say, oh, that's not true. Like, some places will not do the procedure or whatever. In Turkey, you can get an abortion at a public hospital for free. In plenty of places, you can get an abortion in state-sponsored hospitals.